वेलकम टू लेक्चर टू ऑफ यूनिट टू ग्राफ दैट इज ग्राफ रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट एडवांस्ड डेटा स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग. सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन सम ऑफ द डेफिनेशंस एंड टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ ग्राफ. इन दिस लेक्चर वी कवर ग्राफ रिप्रेजेंटेशन दैट इज मैट्रिक्स एंड लीस्ट रिप्रेजेंटेशन. Graph G can be represented in various ways. So three common ways are, that is most common ways are, adjacency matrix, adjacency list and adjacency multilist. So of this we'll see adjacency matrix. So adjacency matrix of graph G, which is a set of V and E having n vertices where n is greater than or equal to 1, is a two-dimensional representation. If graph has n vertices, then there it will form a n cross n array. So assume that we consider A as the array. So A of ij is equal to 1 if and only if there is age which is nothing but a connection of vertex vi to vj. So here if I assume that this A is the matrix of n cross A, so if I have some edge from say vi to vj, that is vertex 1 to vertex 2, so here that entry 1 to 2 is marked as 1, otherwise that entry is marked 0. For example, as there is no edge from 1 to 1, that is vertex 1 to 1, so all these diagonal entries are 0. So being a complete graph, you will find that all the entries except diagonal entries are marked 1, as there is always a connection from 1 to 2, 2 to 1. Consider few more graph representations. So here we are having a tree representation. So T comprises of nodes A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So we have n cross n matrix, that is 7 by 7 matrix, and the headers are A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So as there is connection from A to B and B to A, so there is entry marked A to B 1 and B to A 1. Similarly, A to C and C to A, so A to C 1 and C to A 1. But as there is no connection from B to C, so B to C, so B to C, so here B to C, so it is marked as 0. Now here your graph also can be of say some string Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. So again there will be a matrix of n cross n, set that is 3 by 3. So as there is connection, being a directed graph, as there is connection from Sunday to Monday, so we'll have a Sunday to Monday mark 1. So Monday to Sunday, so Monday to Sunday mark 1. But as there is no entry from Sunday to Tuesday, so Sunday to Tuesday it is 0. So here for a directed graph, row sum is the out degree and column sum is the in degree. So if we sum up this row, so for Sunday there is only 1 as the out degree. If you see that Sunday has only 1 out degree. And if we sum up the columns, so Sunday has only 1 in degree. So that is, this is the 1 in degree from Monday to Sunday. So this way you can easily represent the graph. Now, for a weighted graph, assume that this graph is weighted as shown over here, that we are having a graph with 4 vertices P, C, D, E, and these are connected. So these edges are having weight, that is A of ij is equal to W. So W is some weight. For example, for edge I to j, so assume that I is vertex B and j is vertex C. So for this A of ij, there is weight 12. So again we have a n cross n representation of this graph, matrix representation, and as there is connection from B to C with weight 12, so from B to C you will find that here we have added weight 12. So instead of 1 and 0, we are here either specifying the weight W, or if no connection and no weight, then we are specifying 0. So similarly, we have a edge D to C with weight 9, so here D to C with weight 9. So, yeah. for adjacency matrix representation of the given graph, whatever algorithms we apply to process the graph, so these algorithms will require the time of big of n square, and also these algorithm will require n square minus n entries to be examined, as we are having n cross n matrix for a given graph, and as the diagonal entries are zero, so n square minus those n entries, diagonal entries for all the nodes, so these many entries will be examined by any algorithm. Now for a graph which is sparse, that is it has most of the entries marked as 0 and very few entry marked as 1, so it will require a time complexity of big O of e plus n, where e is number of edges and n is number of vertices, and in this case basically as there are very less connections, so you will find that value of e is very very less than n square by 2. Now coming to the adjacency least part, so we are having a representation of a graph in form of adjacency least. So all these nodes of a graph, for example, for this given graph 1, 2, 3, 4 will form a header of the least. So each of these nodes will form a header of the list. So we'll be having one structure called header node structure. And for each of these header node, we'll maintain a list of adjacent nodes for that particular header. For example, for this header node 1, so 2, 3 and 4 are adjacent nodes. So we'll maintain here adjacency list 2, 3 and 4. Similarly for node 2, 1, 3 and 4, for node 3, 1, 2 and 4, and for node 4, 1, 2 and 3. So this way, for any representation of graph with adjacency least, so it will require n header nodes, so as we have seen here, and 2e least nodes, so these are 2e, that is 2 into e, e is number of edges, so it will be as much as twice of the number of edges in the for the given graph. Now assume the directed graph of days of week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. So here for Sunday there is only one node connected, which that is Sunday is tail and Monday is head. So we are having its node only node in the list, that is Monday. For Monday, so Monday is connected to Sunday as well as Tuesday. So there are two outgoing edges. So we maintain here two nodes for this header Monday. And for Tuesday, there is nothing, as the edge going from Tuesday to another node, so it is null. And this way, the degree of any vertex is number of nodes in its adjacency. So for example, degree of Sunday is 1, so it is out degree obviously. Degree of Monday is 2, so out degree is Sunday and Tuesday for Monday, and for degree of Tuesday is 0. And out degree of any vertex is also number of nodes in its adjacency list. So total number of edges in G can be determined in time n plus e, where n is number of nodes and e is number of edges. So the in degree of this representation, that is directed graph, can be also represented or maintained using inverse adjacency list as shown in figure 7, that Sunday has in degree 1, Monday has 1 and Tuesday has 1. So each of these nodes has 1 degree, 1 in degree. Now adjacency multilist, so we can also represent the graph as adjacency multilist. So multilist node structure is little bit complicated. It maintains 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 feeds. So this M is nothing but a spatial one bit mark field which indicates whether that particular age has been processed or not, or has been visited or examined or not. So after M we have a source vertex, then destination vertex, that is the age, then link for source vertex and links for destination vertex. So for this graph, complete graph of four nodes 1 2 3 4, so we have this vertex, that is the header, and we have at least one entry for each of these ages. So we are having total 6 entries for ages, like age 1 2 2 1 2 3 1 2 4 2 2 3 2 2 4 3 2 4. Now for vertex we have this chain of least, that is n1 n2 n3. That means we, for vertex 1 there are 3 adjacent, for vertex 1 there are 2 nodes maintained as a multi list, so n1 n2 n3. So n1 is 1 to 2, n2 is 1 to 3, and n3 is 1 to 4. So as we see here, obviously 1 to 2, 1 to 3 and 1 to 4. Now for vertex 2, there is a multi-list maintained, n1, n4 and 5. So n1 is 1 to 2, n4 is 2 to 3 and n5 is 2 to 4. So this way for vertex 3 and 4, it is n2, n4, n6, and for 4, n3, n5, n6. Thank you so much. We'll continue in the next lecture.